Gross Valley is presenting EDIUS 9.30 here at IBC 2018. Here with me is Alex, the product manager of EDIUS. And Alex, I would like to know a little bit about future things. We see here EDIUS 9.3. We have a podcast where we show the different new functions. We know that many of the things you have included now were definitely things wished by customers. Do you know there are some more wishes? Maybe you can talk a little bit about the future of EDIUS 9.
Yeah, we're continuing development on EDIUS. We have a schedule for, several upgrades coming in the future. Yeah. So, soon on we hope to deliver the, functionalities that are, well being asked for. So that includes some of the things that are in, the long wish lists, and also that some of the things that we've already promised before, but we haven't delivered yet.
Okay. So things like audio sync?
Yes. So I can say that definitely we're working on it. Yep. We weren't able to deliver yet, but hopefully it's high on the list, and hopefully we can deliver soon.
That's good news. Here at IBC booth, you're showing EDIUS side by side with Rio and other products which came from the SAM side. Is there any news regarding that?
So we've just announced the new version of Rio, version 4.5, here at IBC. So that's, the new version of Rio hasn't come out for a while. So that's a real sort of a big announcement that we've done here. And then moving on to the future, actually the engineering EDIUS engineering team in Kobe will also be taking care of the development of Rio going on to the future. So that would mean that there will be more things coming into Rio, like format support or other, other functionalities, bug fixes, feature requests that are coming in. And also in the future, we will look into more tighter integration between Rio and EDIUS, and also maybe like merging functionalities or moving functionalities from one software to the other.
Yeah, I mean, Rio is used in very different areas, somehow also in the news area because of some optimization things which are included, but also in high-end editing and grading, like for 8K, for really cinema movies. And these technologies, some of them might come to EDIUS.
Yeah. Yes. Actually, there's a big user population of Rio in Japan. Actually, we have many users using EDIUS too, but Rio is living in another different area, high-end post-production for like cinema and drama. And also like animation is a big industry in Japan. And Rio is being used a lot, especially for fine-tuning the colors, which is crucial for animation. So it's a big popular tool, and we are looking forward to be able to get feedback from these customers and also bringing in the Rio technology into EDIUS so that we can provide a good tool for many of these people.
Talking again a little bit about the life cycle of EDIUS 9. EDIUS 9 was introduced 1 year ago. We have seen now your update 9.1, 9.2, now 9.3. So this will continue and for quite a long time?
Well, our normal software span is about roughly 2 years. That's been for the past two versions. But I think maybe like for EDIUS 9, that may be go a little bit longer. We don't know for how long yet, but we hope to provide a lot of the functionalities that were mentioned to be available in the EDIUS 9 range. Yeah.
So that gives a good value to everybody who's buying EDIUS 9.
Hopefully. Although, I'm sorry, but I can't, be quoted to that yet. Yeah. But we will try to do as much as we can.
Okay, thank you very much and have a great IBC.
Thank you very much.